All right, I'm back again. This time, I didn't always have a sawmill. And before I had a sawmill, to get free wood, I had to break these down. This one is for display only. It's a crappy pallet. It's soaked. It's been sitting out in the side yard. If you don't do this and you're looking for a quick way to break them down, well, not a quick way. I mean, there's no quick or easy way to break a pallet down unless you just straight cut with a skill saw or something like that. However, I take the nails out to get as much usable wood as I can off it. And the first thing you want to look for when choosing through pallets is you want to look on the side. It'll either say HT or MB or nothing. But there'll be a stamp. Now this one, I don't know. I think it had it at one point. I wouldn't have took it if it was MB. MB is means it's sprayed with a pesticide, and you don't want to use that. You probably don't even want to be sanding that. Just leave those alone. Just only take the ones that say HT. It stands for heat treated, or I can't remember if they say K for kiln dried. I think they just say HT though. Okay, so without any further delay, I'm going to show you what I do. Claw hammer. A small sledge. Two pry bars. Don't need the tape measure. As you can see, I have it spanned one bench to another, and I secured it with clamps so it can't move. Very simple. Just get your pry bars in on each side. I stick to one side at a time. That way you're not jumping around this sucker. You don't really want to do that, but like I said, this pallet's crap. And sometimes you get lucky and they come right up. Thank you. And sometimes they're gonna pull through the nails. Sometimes there's nothing you can do. The end is just so split. No matter how hard you try, you're not gonna save it all. But what you wanna do is you wanna try to get those nails pried up right now as much as you can. Because the next step, we're gonna come through with the claw hammer and this, and we're gonna get some of the stubborn ones that pull through and they may not be up high enough. So if you just start pulling this sucker up and you break all these few inches of these boards and just pull the nails through, the next step's gonna take you longer. Sometimes they fall right out. Okay, so when you get to the bottom ones, the end closest to you right here, bust it loose with the pry bars, and then when you're tapping on the center one, tap left, tap right, tap center, or whatever order you want. Just don't keep beating on one side. You want to take it down evenly. Oh, my little makeshift stand's gonna fall over. You just want to take it down evenly. See that? And sometimes, there's another trick too. I don't usually do this because you get more breakage this way. But you take your sledge. And then the main thing with this, doing this with a block, you got to listen to the wood. If you're wailing on the sucker and it's not coming, or you get it to move and then it all of a sudden stops at a certain point, that's because you're still tight somewhere else and the whole board's being bent farther than it wants to bend. And that's how you snap boards or crack them. Okay, now take my little pry bars, my claw hammer. See, this board's all split up. There's no saving this end at all. Slam shut.
press one of these clamps loose. And I'm going to spin this around just a little bit. There we go. And at this point, you can pretty much unclamp the whole thing. Because it's basically ready to come apart. Just like so. And we're going to use the rest of this pallet to stabilize it. We're going to take our little sledge and we're going to tap this. Just to get some wiggle room out of it. Oh yeah, I found the, I'll show you what that. Sometimes they're a little stubborn. And this is oak. I won't be throwing this piece away. It's a nice piece of wood here. I don't know what I'll do with it yet, but I'll do something with it. Where'd you go? This last one? I just saw it. It's on this one. Yeah, it's right there.
If you can see in there, right there. And right there, it's the same stamp over and over again. It says real small, HT. And sometimes they're bigger. That just means it's heat treated to kill the critters and it's not sprayed with pesticides, which means this pallet is safe to use for furniture or whatever application you want to use it for. And you don't have to worry about sanding it other than the normal, you know, things to consider when sanding. If you see MB, just stay away from it. Don't even touch it. And if it's not labeled at all, just leave it alone. Don't use it. There's many, many other pallets that say HT that they're probably going to be free to. Just save yourself the possible long-term risks of breathing that stuff in. Okay, after 18 minutes, this is what I look like. I'm left with a pile like this. Okay, now I'm going to show you what you need to do the rest of this. All right, for this step, removing all the nails and anything that could be sticking out of the wood, you're going to want a set of side cutters. Don't go pulling out your nice snap-ons, okay? Get you a messed up, screwed up pair. Get your oldest pair out of your box, or go buy a cheap, inexpensive pair, because your nice side cutters are going to be worth a crap after this. And these are for the little bits like that. The nail done broke. You're going to need these to go something like that. Just grab that sucker, flush up against the wood, and then just pry down, and it'll pull up eventually. Now, you do want a little bit of an edge on these things. Like, mine's really dull, because this is what I use this pair for. So they don't bite as well as they used to. So, you know, it might be beneficial to go get a Harbor Freight pair for $2, because it'll have a nice, decent edge on it, because you want it to get some bite. You just don't want it to shear the head off. So, if you have to, just take a file and maybe, you know, make it a little duller. Okay, then we're gonna get the pallet wood, right? Now we're down to nails. Boom. Oh, see, busted head off. Side cutters. Done. No nails. That piece is done. Okay. As you can see, some of these pallets, just from being repaired like this, and they just don't make it easy. As you can see, that is just a whole nesting mess of nails and broken nails, and these get to be a little time consuming sometimes. Now, these, just kind of got to consider what's the best tool. You know, is it going to be the flat bar or the hammer? I generally use, I go back and forth, you know. Sometimes I'll use both tools. Hand. Oops. There we go. No, I'm not left-handed, by the way. Up. Now, leverage on it. Sorry, Mr. Spider. I'm doing a video. Once you get into a rhythm, it really goes kind of quick. See that? No, you guys can't see that. It's all right. Just hurry up a little bit here. Got a bucket down here. I'm dumping my nails in. Arrgh, got stuck. All right, that was done. Now, these are the fun ones. These ones go pretty quick. Put my hand there, get it as close as I can as that block on that block, and just tap them straight, tap them down. Off the table. See the side that just came down? Those are off the table now, so that I don't have to fight them. Sometimes you're going to need to use your dykes or your side cutters to straighten up the nails so you can get them. You can drive it through like this one. These ones are a pain. There we go. Make it easy on yourself. Get the easiest side you can done first so that it lays down flat. It's easier to work with it.
Wow! That felt There we go. So this is normally what I would do, would be for these I would probably just use the side of the table, but it just depends on. Probably see this much better. Should have done this the whole time. Thank you. I'm gonna ride my bucket. I couldn't do that again if I tried. That one didn't have any in it. That little baby Black Widow is running all over the place. Oh, my friend's about to fall out. These are the last two. Oh, it's got a head on it. Now it doesn't. This one might take a minute. So you put your hand on the back, you get your dykes underneath like this, see that, under the nail that broke, this on the bench, hand pushing down, and you just, well, or you just break it. Of course, the one I try to give you an example on is the one that gives me a bear of a time. Look at that, stood straight up. One side. Believe me, the nails add up faster than you might think if you're doing 6-7 of these things. Pick up your nails as you go. It's no time now versus a half an hour sleeping later. Here. See again.
This side has two. Yeah, just two. And this side has three. Only three. So I'm just gonna do these two first. Oops. Maybe. Now I have the flat edge that I can just hold it down with one hand. And I just wedge it up against my body, push one hand down, and that's it. Assuming I can get the nail out of the claw. Okay. So that's it. Took about 33, 35 minutes, and that was with explaining and stopping and talking, but we got three 1x6s. I think they're around 40 inches long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Basically 1x4s. Probably about the same, maybe just a little touch shorter. And then these, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with these yet. It actually has really nice grain. They're oak. Can't mistake that grain anywhere. That's oak. So I don't know what I'll do with that, but maybe butcher block or something eventually. Sand it down, cut it up. Do something with it. It actually came out better than I thought. The way the pallet looked, I didn't think I was going to be able to save that much, and I almost didn't even do the video because I was actually afraid of butchering the damn pallet and looking like a fool. All right, well, hey, I hope this video helped you out. Remember, just get it up off the ground. When I first started doing this, I was on the ground, on my knees. Oh my God, it was the worst. Getting it up off the ground using two benches really, really helps. If you don't have benches, break down a couple pallets and build a couple benches out of the pallets. You don't need a tabletop. All you need is something to put it up 30 inches in the air or so. The higher the better. Not too high because you want to be able to leverage down. That's about it. You know, two cat claws or two pry bars. 2 to 4 clamps. A claw hammer. A little sledge. And 30 minutes is all you need. Like, honestly, I can do them in 20. Some of them are more stubborn than others. You can tell, like, when you pick, right? You're looking for HT, like I said. And then you're also looking for, does it look like it's been repaired a whole bunch? Because if it looks like it's been repaired a lot, like look at the slats, if they look newer than the other slats, chances are there's a mess of nails in there. Because when they fix these things, they don't pull the nails out. They hammer those sons of bitches down into the side rails, and then they put a new slat right over top of it. And so when you start pulling these slats off, there's just a smorgasbord of nails. So look for that, okay? Look for end checking or cracking on the ends of the boards. It's kind of a lot of crappy lighting in here, but look for end checking on the ends of the boards. The more check this is, the more crack this is, the less likely it is you're going to be able to save the wood. So always, you know, you're never going to get 100%, okay? When you're dealing with pallets, I would expect 30% loss minimum. This was a lucky pallet. And, you know, wear gloves. I probably should have, but this wood is really wet, so I wasn't too worried about splinters. But, you can get them. I would have wore gloves if this wood wasn't soaked. Well, anyways, I hope this helped you guys out. The next video I'm going to do, I'm going to take this same pallet. I'm going to leave it right here. I'm not even going to move it. And I'm going to build, a little picket fence out of it to hide your hose reel in your front yard. It's easy to do. It takes a few screws, and it's going to look nice. So I don't know when I'm going to put that up. I'm probably going to make it right now. If I don't, it'll be tomorrow, but I don't know when I'll edit the video up. But it'll be sometime later in the week, maybe by the weekend. Like I've said before, videos are a little slow right now just because of the weather, and I don't have any usable logs right now. Everything's tied up in the kiln, and until I can finish that and get some logs coming in to cut and turn into wood, you know, it's just videos like these. So just be patient. We'll get the channel up and running. Like I said, I'm hopeful to have a CNC machine here by summertime, maybe a little later than that. And then the fun's really going to begin. So, hey, I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. And just remember, free wood. I mean, you're going to do a little bit of work, but if you do it right, you can tear these suckers down with minimal loss and minimal pain on your back and knees. So, hope this helped you guys out. Like, share, subscribe, and till the next video, I'm out.